Beaker Beat.
It's Monday, November 21st, 2011. In this week's Beaker Beat, Pfizer concocts a plan to beat the generic competition for Lipitor, but will it work? Plus, could it be true? A bipartisan bill that would help medical device companies is introduced. We have the details of this shocking development.
You think we should have rented a bigger car?
And our Muppet namesake is back on the silver screen this holiday season, but not before he appears at a wrestling match? Watch Beaker wreak havoc in this week's edition of Beaker Beat, brought to you by Life Technologies. To learn more about Life Technologies, visit their company webpage on beaker.com.
It's time to get things started on the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, motivational.
Calling.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here. Hello everyone, welcome to this week's edition of Beaker Beat. I'm Mike Justice. Thanks for tuning in. We've got Kermit here because, you know, it's a big week for us here at Beaker. The Muppets have a new movie coming out, and we're big fans of the Muppets. You know, I resemble Kermit. He's follically challenged, and he loves pork. I love pork. Who doesn't? As for Jeremy, I think he mostly resembles the weird fish-throwing guy and that hairy, random homeless guy who keeps showing up. Kind of like he is at work. Anyway, we'll have more with Kermit and the Muppets throughout the show, but first, here's this week's top story. With the patent on Lipitor expiring in just a few days, Pfizer has found an interesting way to squeeze a few more bucks out of its blockbuster drug, but some folks are crying foul. The New York Times reports Pfizer has struck a deal with some big benefit companies, like Medco Health Solutions and others, who are telling pharmacists to continue filling prescriptions with the more expensive Lipitor once Pfizer's patent expires and generic competition kicks in. Critics of this type of deal say it only benefits managers like Medco at the expense of consumers, their employers, and taxpayers. According to a letter from Catalyst Rx, a benefit manager for 18 million people in the United States, Pfizer has agreed to large discounts for benefit managers that block the use of generic versions of Lipitor. The letters have not previously been made public. No surprise, not something you want floating around. Now, the power of benefits managers has been growing as competition among them has fallen. Big boys like Medco, Express Scripts, and others have been gobbling up smaller competitors to strengthen their bargaining position. Pharmacy benefits managers act as middlemen for drug makers, pharmacies, and health plan sponsors, negotiating prices and managing the use of drugs by patients. Their profits are tied to cutting their clients' drug costs. Pharmacists United for Truth and Transparency, an advocacy group for independent pharmacists, said Medco is among pharmacy benefit managers blocking reimbursements for generic Lipitor in a, quote, blatant attempt to retain rebate dollars, end quote, from Pfizer. Health plan sponsors will pay an estimated $35 more per prescription for brand name Lipitor than they would for a generic version. That according to a pharmacist and spokesman for the organization. Now, Pfizer's plan could be a boon. If they can keep Lipitor sales flowing at 40% for 6 months, it would make $932 million off the drug in 2012, about four times more than the usual 10% rate. So tell us what you think about this story or any story that you see in today's show. Very simple. Click on the orange button below me. A box will pop up. Type in your comment. Send it to me. I promise I'll read and respond to every one of them. It's not easy being green, is it? You know who else is green all the time? Jeremy. He's envious of my rugged good looks.
And we're putting our money where our mouth is when we say we want to hear from you. We want you to send us a photo of you or you and your coworkers together while surfing Beaker.com or watching Beaker Beat. Just like this one by Jeremy, although you don't have to look that ridiculous. We're giving away two prizes at the end of the year for two categories. One for the most people in the photo, easy. Another for the most creative photo. What are the prizes, you ask? Is it a pony? No. A massage from Jeremy? Thank goodness, no.
A new Porsche!
Hey, I'm not Bob Barker. Although I did spay and neuter my pets. Don't worry, it's a surprise, but it'll be worth it. So start snapping those pictures and send them to BeakerBeat at Beaker.com.
Come on, line up. This is serious business. All right, one, two, three, four.
5, 6, 7, 8. We better run for it, Patrol Man!
A bipartisan group has introduced a bill to accelerate the FDA approval process for medical devices by making it easier for the agency to consult with experts, along with other provisions. The bill, the Patient Access to Medical Innovation Act, would require the FDA to comply with the same conflict of interest requirements as the NIH and all other federal agencies. According to the bill's sponsors, stringent restrictions on panel members now often prevent the best experts from reviewing specific devices or technologies and thus significantly slowing the approval process.
The bill would also lift the current profit cap on devices used to treat rare conditions and diseases that go through a special approval process. Meanwhile, Consumers Union urged Congress to strengthen the law that governs the approval of medical devices. The consumer group wants Congress to ensure that all implantable and life-sustaining medical devices are subject to more rigorous review by the FDA, and to establish a better system for tracking devices after approval so patients and doctors can be notified when safety problems arise.
This is near.
Looking for crickets? Found some you have,
Okay, I know Yoda's not a real Muppet, but he sounds like Grover, so we're gonna go with it.
A panel of FDA experts voted 14-1 in favor of Pfizer's Prevnar 13 for adult use, paving the way for a likely approval in January. The panel determined the vaccine protected adults over 50 from pneumococcal infections more effectively than Merck's Pneumovax, which is currently the only approved vaccine to prevent pneumococcal infections in adults. Pfizer wants to expand Prevnar 13 to adult use. It's currently only approved for children 6 weeks to 5 years. Meanwhile, the FDA pulled the plug on Roche's Avastin for use against breast cancer after a protracted battle over the popular cancer drug. In revoking that use, FDA Commissioner Margaret Hamburg said Avastin was not shown to be safe and effective. Avastin will remain on the market for other uses, including certain types of colon, lung, kidney, and brain cancer. Sandoz agreed to pay $150 million to settle claims brought by a whistleblower and the states of California and Florida. The litigation accused pharmaceutical companies of reporting inflated drug values to Medicaid programs. The IMS Institute for Healthcare Informatics has analyzed the drug shortage problem, calling it, quote, highly concentrated product-wise. The drugs represent just a small part of the overall pharma market. More than 100 companies supply the 168 products on the shortages list. Over 80% of the scarce meds are generics, and more than 80% are injectables. 16% of the drugs with supply problems are oncology meds. To combat the problem, IMS Institute recommends the FDA or industry set up some kind of early warning system to improve monitoring of the drug supply. The company conducting the world's first clinical trial of a therapy using human embryonic stem cells is halting that trial and leaving the stem cell business entirely. Geron Corp, facing money issues, will focus on its experimental cancer therapies, which are further along in development. The Menlo Park, California-based company will cut 66 jobs, or 38% of its staff, as a result. Mako Surgical Group announced 100 new jobs with support from state and local incentives. The Davie, Florida-based company expanded its manufacturing facility for its robotic arm interactive orthopedic surgical robot by 30,000 square feet. It has been fueled by rapid sales of its device, which helps doctors perform hip and knee replacement surgeries more accurately. Mako expects to grow to 500 employees by the end of 2012. St. Jude Medical will transfer its R&D operations to a newly purchased facility in Sunnyvale, California. The device company has allotted $5.7 million to renovate the new R&D office.
I think its man is sick. You ought to see a doctor.
But Dr. Bob, you are a doctor.
That's your opinion. I'm getting out of here.
As we recently reported, Medtronic had been mulling the sale of its external defibrillator division, and now they pulled the trigger. Bain Capital has agreed to buy Medtronic's Physio Control for nearly $500 million in cash. The deal should be done in the first quarter of next year. Biocartis has secured $100 million in a round of Series C financing from Johnson & Johnson and other investors. The Swiss company will use the money to support the development of its flagship Apollo device, targeted for release in 2013. Baxter has finalized its takeover of Baxa. The $380 million buyout will allow Baxter to expand its nutrition IV device offering. I've heard of not taking no for an answer, but this is kind of ridiculous. LabCorp is again extending its offer for shares of DNA testing company Orchid Cellmark. The company said 26 million shares of Orchid Cellmark had been tendered in support of the offer, representing about 80% of the company's diluted shares. The offer will now expire November 30th. This is the ninth time LabCorp has bid for Orchid Cellmark.
Oh, Jeremy, are you scared? Oh, you will be. You will be.
Time to play the music.
It's time to light the lights.
It's time to meet the Muppets.
Yes! Come on, guys, let's go!
Finally, it's opening week for the latest feature film from our favorite group of fuzzy, lovable goofballs. No, not me and Jeremy. The Muppets. Kermit, Fozzie, and the gang return to the silver screen for what should be a fun-filled romp of silliness and nonsense, which is, of course, right up our alley. Speaking of that, our favorite Muppet, Beaker, was doing his part to promote the film at a wrestling match.
Hey!
That's right, the poor put-upon assistant to Dr. Bunsen Honeydew was rumbling in the ring. Now, no doubt, this looks like a normal Thanksgiving Day gathering for some of you. It does for me, only with less blood. Anyway, this has nothing to do with the life sciences biz, we just love the Muppets, and Beaker particularly. So, after you stuff your face with turkey, go see the film. If you're watching this show, chances are, you'll enjoy it.
Well, that's it for this week's edition of Beaker Beat. I'm Mike Justice. For Kermit and Yoda,
thank you for watching, we do. See you again next week, we will.
Okay. Let's hit the road. We gotta go find this rainbow connection. Someday we'll find it.
The rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Sit, Beaker. Sit. Good dog.
Thank you for watching. We'll see you again, we will.
I forgot what I was saying. Okay, 3, 2, 1.